Good morning. Bonjour. Guten Morgen. Thank you, Amber, for your introduction and your hard work all day in this business forum. And thank you, Yvonne, and the Canadian German Chamber of Industry and Commerce for organizing today's event. Perrin, it's good to have you with us and so many Canadian business leaders alongside you. Of course, Olaf, Chancellor Scholz, thank you for your remarks and for gathering so many German business leaders here as well. It really is a testament to how seriously not just your government, but the German economy is taking this potential for deepening already strong trade ties and partnership ties with Canada. Of course, on my side, I'm joined today by Deputy Prime Minister Freeland and Ministers François-Philippe Champagne, Mélanie Joly, and Jonathan Wilkinson, who are helping lead investments across our economy that are generating clean innovation, new technologies, and of course, good, well-paying jobs. Germany is one of Canada's most significant trading partners, with almost $26 billion in merchandise trade last year. Our strong business-to-business ties are also evident in the almost $32 billion worth of direct investment from Germany into our economy. And this is a growing trade relationship. Last year, trade between our countries was up 14% compared to what it was before CETA. Le Canada et l'Allemagne partagent la vision d'un avenir où nos économies sont résilientes et carboneutres. Et pour bâtir cet avenir, on doit s'assurer d'augmenter notre capacité de production d'énergie propre. In the face of the current geopolitical situation with Russia weaponizing fossil fuel exports, we are standing shoulder to shoulder with our European friends and allies. Canada is doing our part to add to the global energy supply right now. But it has never been clearer why we need to accelerate the green transition. And you should have no doubts that Canada has what it takes to be a supplier of clean energy in a net zero world. On a les travailleurs, les entreprises, le savoir-faire et la volonté nécessaire pour fournir au monde l'énergie dont il a besoin, dont il aura encore plus besoin dans les décennies à venir. Ici, on parle évidemment en partie du gaz naturel, mais on parle aussi de possibilités comme la biomasse, les minéraux critiques et l'hydrogène, bien sûr. L'investissement commercial est crucial et ce ne sont pas les opportunités qui manquent. Chaque région du Canada a le potentiel de participer à cet effort. When it comes to clean energy, Canada means business. You'll see proof of this later today when Olaf and I visit Stephenville in Newfoundland and Labrador. L'électrification, incluant l'électrification des véhicules, est aussi un élément important de notre plan pour faire croître une économie propre et prospère. Le Canada a ce qu'il faut pour répondre à une demande en véhicules électriques qui continue d'augmenter. Global investors know that Canada is a reliable strategic partner when it comes to our EV future. Recently, we've made investments alongside car manufacturers like Ford and Stellantis, and battery manufacturers like Umicore and Germany's own BASF. And shortly, we'll have some really great announcements from Volkswagen and Mercedes-Benz. And this isn't just good for industry and the climate. This is good for workers. The investments across Canada this year alone in everything from building hybrids to EVs to EV batteries have secured almost 17,000 great jobs. Because that's what it's all about at the end of the day. Real opportunities that benefit people. C'est important, comme chef de gouvernement et d'entreprise, de ne jamais oublier qu'on est redevable non seulement aux actionnaires et aux intervenants, mais aussi aux gens, aux travailleurs, aux communautés. When we support the middle class, when we put people at the center, we create the conditions for growth. Our government has made a point to invest in the critical social infrastructure that supports workers and families. I'm talking about programs like the $10 a day childcare, which alone is projected to grow our economy by 1.2%. Or, increases we've made to the federal minimum wage and income benefits for low-income workers. Programs like these are helping Canada achieve historic reductions in income inequality and ensuring a strong and resilient workforce. L'économie, c'est les gens. C'est pour ça qu'on place l'emploi au cœur de notre plan de relance économique suite à la COVID-19. Les résultats parlent d'eux-mêmes. Le Canada a récupéré tous les emplois qu'on avait perdus durant la pandémie 9 mois avant que les États-Unis l'ont fait. Le taux de chômage est maintenant le plus bas que jamais et on continue notre travail. We've got ambitious plans. We want to work with German partners to create good, family-sustaining jobs on both sides of the Atlantic today and, more importantly, well into the future. There's huge potential in the innovative and research-heavy sectors that provide highly paid, skilled jobs. Talking about areas, as Olaf mentioned, like artificial intelligence and quantum technologies. Both Canada and Germany are committed to the responsible development and use of these technologies. On a aussi des secteurs en forte croissance comme la biofabrication et les sciences de la vie qui, en plus de créer des opportunités, protègent la santé des gens. Canada is the most educated country in the OECD, and our open immigration policies are attracting talent in competitive industries. Germany is a true friend and partner of Canadian business, creating opportunities to celebrate and showcase the exceptional talent and expertise of Canadians across industries, including in the cultural center, where just last fall, Canada was the guest of honor at the Frankfurt Book Fair. But as Olaf mentioned, as perhaps more interest to this room, we should all be really pleased that Canada has accepted Germany's gracious invitation for 2025 to be a featured partner at Hannover Messe, the world's leading industry and technology world fair, trade fair. The competitiveness of Canadian businesses is evident for everyone here to see. We have tremendous opportunities ahead of us, and I look forward to the work that we're all going to do together. Je tiens à remercier mon ami Olaf encore une fois pour sa visite au Canada et pour votre présence tous ensemble. Merci d'être ici aujourd'hui, mais merci surtout pour tout le travail que nous allons faire ensemble dans les années à venir. Merci.